Hello, class 11. How are you all? So welcome to the revision series. And today we are going to do the revision of the chapter that is vectors. The vector is in the chapter of class chapter number 4, that is motion in a plane. But the part of vector is really important to us because that part of vector will repeat in the whole physics. So let us clear some concept with help of some important questions. All right. So the first question is. Vector A is there whose value is given 2i cap plus 4j cap minus 5k2. Okay, so this is a rectangular form. This is known as the rectangular form of a vector A. Now what we have to do, we have to find the first, that is mod of A. Okay, so mod of A means we have to find the magnitude. The second thing, we have to find the unit vector, that is the unit vector of A, or you can say the vector which is representing the direction of vector A, that we have to find. And the third thing is we have to find direction cosines. Direction cosines. Alright. So let us find the first thing, that is the magnitude. So you all know that if we have a vector that is given in a rectangular form, what we do to find the magnitude, just take the under root and take the square of each of the component of the x axis, that is I cap, y cap and j cap. Okay, so we are taking the coefficient, that is 2 square plus 4 square plus 25. Okay, let me write first, that is 5 square. Alright, so this will be what? This will be 4 plus 16 and plus 25. Okay, so if you add up them all, you will get value, that is root 45. So this is what? The mod of A. Okay, that is the magnitude of A. Now let's talk about the unit vector. So what is the unit vector? Unit vector is one which have the first thing, that is having a magnitude of 1, and it gives us the direction of the vector for which it is defined. So here we are defining for A, that means it will give the direction of the vector A. Alright, so this is given as the ratio of vector A upon mod of vector A. Alright, so now we have already calculated the value of mod of A. So what we will write? We will write A cap is equal to, that is 2i cap plus 4j cap minus 5k cap and complete divided by what? That is the root 45. Okay, so you all can see this value is giving us the direction of the vector. Alright, so this is clear. Now the third thing is direction cosine. Okay, direction cosine. So I told you what is the direction of sine. That when there is a three-dimensional vector, or you can say the two-dimensional vector, so what happens? If I just take an example of a two-dimensional vector, a 2D vector. Okay? So what you can see, this is our y, this is our x, and let's say this is our vector. Let's take a vector d. Let's take a vector d, alright? So it is having a component on the x-axis also and the y-axis also. Okay, so if I am using the term of angles, let's say it is making bending with the x-axis as alpha and the angle with y-axis as, that is beta. Okay, so if I am using the angles to define the direction of our vector for each individual axis. Okay, for x axis the angle is alpha, for y axis it is a beta. So this angles is given in the form of cos alpha and cos beta, and that is known as the direction cosines. Okay, so direction cosines are basically representation of the angle in terms of cos, which will give you the direction of the vector. Alright, so the first cosines of our vector is, now here we have a three dimension, so we have a three cosines. Okay, so the first is cos alpha. And what is cos alpha? That is the component of vector A on x axis upon the magnitude of A. Okay, so what is that value on the x-axis, which is 2. So what is that value of cos alpha? This is 2/245. So this is our first cosine, that is cos alpha. Okay, similarly we will take the, we will write for the other terms also, that is cos beta. The cos beta, which will be written as ay upon mod of a. Okay, so what is that? That is simply the value ay. What is ay? It is 4. So this is 4 upon root 45. And similarly cos gamma, that is given for the component az upon mod of a. What is that? Minus 5 upon root 45. Okay, so all these terms are what? All these terms are our direction cosines. Okay, so now let's come to the next question. The different question. Okay, so the next question is based on the resolution of the vectors. Resolution of the vectors. Let's say this is the center. This is y axis and this is our x axis. All right. And we have a vector that is acting in this direction. Let's say this is b. Let's say this is b vector. Let it be a vector that is acting downward. Let's say a, and the one vector, let's say this is c. All right. And it is given that it is making an angle 45 degree, and the value of our vector a, this value is given. The mod of a is given to us, that is. That is 5 meters. All right. So what we have to do? We have to find the value magnitude of. We have to find the magnitude. That is the value of b vector and the c vector. So this is our question. Okay. So one angle is given and one value is given of a. That is 5. Okay. That is a mod of 5, and we have to determine the b and the c. Okay. Now, we will use the concept of resolution of vector. Okay. Now you can see this vector is an oblique vector because it is not along either x-axis, not directly along the y-axis. So we can take a component of this. So see here, the c is attached with a 45 angle. So we can take a horizontal component of it, and that will be given as c cos 45. Okay. I am directly using the c as a magnitude of c, and then cos 45. Okay. Similarly, I can write a vertical component of this angle is also 45. So either you take cos or sine, both value will be same. So that's why this is c. Let's take sine 45, no problem, sine 45. Okay. Now you can see that if all these vectors, it is also given in the question, that is all these vectors are balancing each other. Okay. They are balancing each other. So that means what? If it is given the net vector is 0, that is balancing means the net resultant is what? That is 0. Okay, this is given in the last line of the question, that all these are balancing to each other. Okay, so what we can say, the component on y axis is balancing, the component on y axis, the c component on y axis is balancing the vector a. Okay, so you can say this value c sine 45. Okay, this value is balancing the opposite side, that is given as vector a. Okay, so let's put the value c is equal to a upon sine 45. Okay, so what is our a? That is our 5. Sine 45, 1 by root 2, and root 2 will come in the numerator. So it will become 5 root 2. So 5 root 2 is what? It is the magnitude of c. So we got the value of c as 5 root 2. Alright. Now, the next term that is left, which is b. Okay, so let us find for the b. So again you can see we had taken a component. Why we are not taking a? Because you can see both are perpendicular. So even if you want to take the component of a along the b, it will become 90 degree, that is 0. So that's why we are only using the component of c. The horizontal component of c, that is cos 45, which should be balancing the horizontal vector, that is b. Okay. So this is equal to b. Now again let's take the values. So what is the b? So c is 5 root 2 and this 45 means cos 45 means 1 by root 2. So this will cancel out root and again we are getting only 5. So b is 5 meter again, a is also 5 meter and what is our c? That is 5 root 2. So this is the way we can solve using the resolution of the vectors. Okay. Now let's talk about the next question. Okay, so our next question is again based on the vectors properties. Okay, so vector B is given to us. Vector B is given to us, and the value is 3i cap plus 4j cap. Okay, and b is given to us with the values 7i cap and 24j. Alright, so what we have to do, find the vector, that means we have to find the new vector of having magnitude of A and direction of B. Okay, so in this question we have to find another vector that is different from A and B, but it will have a magnitude of A and a direction of B. Okay, so this is the question, that is a hint which is given to us. Okay, so first of all let's calculate, let us say the third vector that we are finding, the vector is, let's take it at the C vector. Okay, so what is given to us, that the magnitude of the C should be equal to magnitude of A. So let's make it equal, magnitude of A, and let's find out what is the magnitude of A. So it will be under root 4 square plus 3 square, that is equal to 16 plus 9, that is 25, which is equal to 5. So 5 is what the magnitude of C. Now the second thing that is given to us, that is the hint. The hint is direction of B. That means the direction of C should be along the direction of B. That means if we calculate our unit vector for the B, because the unit vector will give the direction of vector B. So what does that mean? That unit vector of B is the same direction of the vector C. And then I will multiply with the magnitude to finally get our vector C. Alright? So let us say, direction of the B that is given by unit vector B, which is vector B upon mod of B. So what is that? Alright, so we are solving, this is 7 square plus 24 square. So when you finally write it down, this will become 7i cap plus 24j cap, and this will be exactly equal to 625, and you know the 625 is now what? This is the square of 25. Okay, so what we can finally write, our unit vector b, or you can say direction of our C, this is equal to 7i cap plus 24j cap upon 25. So this is the direction of B, and the same thing it is given, that the vector C should have equal direction of B. Alright, so that means it is also the direction of our C cap. Alright, now if I want to write the complete vector of C, what should I do? I should multiply with the magnitude of the C that we have calculated. Okay, so that we have calculated as 5. So now let's multiply the 5. Let us first write the statement, that will be mod of C, multiply, that is simple multiplication with what? That is the unit vector of B, because this is telling the direction of C and this is telling the direction of, that is the magnitude of C. Alright, so let us multiply. So if I multiply this term B cap with the value of 5, the value is 5, so what you will get? 7i cap plus 24j cap, okay, and divide by 25, and with multiply with 5 you will get 25. So this is the vector field that we were searching for. All right. So this is the solution of this question. Okay. Now let's come to the next part. The one more question is there with the vectors. Okay. So the next question is find the area of parallelogram if the two sides of a vector are given to you. Okay, which are the sides?
The A is given to you, that is 4i cap plus 3j cap.
All right, and the second vector is given to you, that is
B is equal to minus 3i cap
plus 6j cap. Okay, so these are the two sides that are given to us. Now you know from the properties of the cross product, what is this?
That the A cross B, the magnitude of A cross B graphically represents us, that is area of the parallelogram. Okay, area of a parallelogram. So that means what we have to do, we have to do a cross product between the A and B and then finally take out their magnitude. Okay.
So you can see that there is no term of the k cap is not given here. So what we will assume that is a zero.
First, let's draw the chart of A cross B. So this is our I cap, this is our J cap, this is our K cap, and values are 4, 3, 0, and next term is minus 3, 6, 0.
Alright. Now you can see that if I hide the first term, what will happen? 0 is multiplied for both, so you are getting 0 coefficient for the I cap. Again, if I hide the J and cross multiply with them, again we are getting a 0 coefficient for J cap also. But for K cap, if you are hiding this column, you are now getting the value. Okay. So what I can simply write, I is having a 0 coefficient, minus J is also having a 0 coefficient, plus K, we are now getting the value. What is that? If we hide this, 6, 4, 24, this is 24 minus, and this is minus 9. Okay, this is minus 9. What it will be, minus and minus will become plus. So what I can write, that is 24 plus 9 k cap, which is equal to 33 k. Okay, so this is, now I came only in the one unit vector form, and this can be written as the same value as a magnitude. Okay, if there is only one unit vector, you can say this is only the magnitude. So what is our magnitude of A cross B finally?
Which is equal to only 33 square unit.
Alright, so this is the area of our parallelogram. Alright, now if in the question it is also asked that find out the area of the triangle, find out the area of the triangle that is formed by the two sides. Okay, so now if you remember again the formula, what it was? It was that the area of triangle is given by A cross B mod into half. That is half the magnitude of A cross B. So what it will be? It is 33. So what the area of the triangle will be? That will be 33 by the square root. So this was the application based on the cross product. Okay. So I hope you understood the question. Okay, so solve more and more practice problem to get the clarity of the concept. Okay, so thank you all.